Hello friends, my name is Specification, Assistant Professor, Priyadarshini Jail College of Pharmacy, Nagpur. Friends, today we're going to discuss the new topic, SMILES. SMILES is a simplified molecular input line entry specification. With the help of SMILES, you can represent the chemical structure of a compound with a single line notation. As you can see, this is a structure of ascorbic acid, commonly known as vitamin C. The structure of this ascorbic acid can be represented with this single line notation. So this is going to be useful to represent the structure of a chemical compound in a single line. So dear friends, as discussed, what is SMILE? The SMILE is simplified molecular input line entry specification. So the SMILE is a specification in the form of line notation for describing the structure of chemical species. This SMILE notation can consist of chain of letters, numbers, and characters that specify the atoms, their connectivity, bond order, as well as chirality. So, the SMILE notation can be useful to represent any chemical structure with a single line. Let us see this example, the SMILE notation for paracetamol. The structure of paracetamol can be simply written as CCONC1CCCOCC1. This both O are in the brackets. So what this is representing, it is a branching that this carbon is connected with the oxygen via double bond and this carbon is connected to this oxygen via single bond. We'll come to the detail how this SMILE notations are being given. So to understand the SMILE notation, we have to understand first of all the SMILE specification rules. The SMILE specification rules will help you to represent the structure of atom, bonds, to represent the cyclic structures, as well as we can going to represent the branches as we seen earlier. And with the SMILE notation, you can also represent the stereochemistry of any chemical structure. So let us see how the SMILE specification rules are given. Atoms are represented by their atomic symbols only. In case of a metal atom, square brackets are used with the symbols. However, there are certain elements or atoms for which you don't have to use any brackets. For B, C, N, O, P, S and all halides. So, with the help of this specification rules for the atom, you can give a SMILE specification rule for this particular structure. Let us see in this table, elemental gold can be represented as square bracket AU, methane only C, whereas water only O, and iron 2 cation, the ferrous form, is represented in a square bracket Fe2 positive. So this is a simple SMILE notation is giving the information about the structure of a compound. Now let us see the specification rules for the bonds. In case of a single and double bond, the same notation is used, single and double. However, for the triple bond, you have to go for the hashtag sign. So means if any two atoms are connected with the triple bond, you have to represent that connection with this hashtag sign. Adjacent atoms are assumed to be connected to each other by a single or aromatic bonds. So see these examples, ethene can be represented as C double bond C. In case of a formaldehyde, C double bond O. Hydrogen gas is represented in square bracket H followed by square bracket H. So this is representing a connection between the two hydrogen atoms. Hydrogen cyanide, as it is a triple bond, so it should have a notation of hashtag in between carbon and nitrogen. Now, to represent cyclic structures with the SMILE specification rule, there are two types of the cyclic structures. One is aliphatic, another is aromatic. In case of aliphatic compound, all the carbon, oxygen, sulfur and nitrogen atoms are represented in uppercase. However, in case of aromatic structures, carbon, oxygen, sulfur, and nitrogen are represented in lowercase. So, with this example, you can understand in detail. See, the structure of benzene is aromatic. So, to represent the carbons in the benzene, you have to use the small letters, the small C1, C, 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 C1. This first C1 and last C1 is indicating that both these are interconnected. So, it is in the form of a cyclic ring. Similarly, in case of a cyclohexane, the notations are same, but all are case sensitive. So, you have to write capital C1 followed by all capital C and last C1. Again, this first C1 and last C1 are interconnected with each other. So, it is in a cyclic form. Similarly, you can go for the furan, where starting from O1 and ending to C1. So, this is again a cyclization. In case of a naphthalene, as you know, there are two rings, benzene rings available. So, these benzene rings are represented in this format. Now, to represent the branches, the Smile specification rule says the branches are specified by enclosing them in parentheses. Means you have to use brackets to represent the branching. Let us see this example of isobutyl chloride. In case of isobutyl chloride, you can see this methyl group is a branch over this C, C, C and Cl chain. So how it can be represented? See this C, C. This C is the first C, then second. And this methyl group branching can be given in the brackets, it is a capital C, followed by CCl. So, this is how you can represent the isobutyl chloride. Let us see one more example. In case of aspirin, the notation is started from this oxygen, O, double bond C, and methyl is a branch. So, you have to give this methyl in a bracket, only C, followed by oxygen, O. Then it is a small C1 as this is a benzene carbon. So, C1, then C, 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 then C1. From this benzene C1, it is connected with this carboxyl carbon. So, there is a outside the benzene ring, hence it is a capital C, followed by double bond O in bracket as it is a side branch and O. This is representing that this carbon and OH are connected with a single bond and this carbon and oxygen is connected via double bond. Smile specification rule can also be used to represent the stereochemistry of the structures. To represent the cis and trans conformer or to represent the configuration around a double bond, characters like this forward slash and backward slash are used. Two forward slash represent the trans isomer. As you can see, this is a forward slash between fluorine and carbon. And again, this is a forward slash between carbon and fluorine. So, two forward slash represent the trans isomer. One forward and one backward slash represent the cis isomer. So, with the help of Smile notation, you can also represent the configuration around a double bond. Now, to represent configuration at the tetrahedral carbon, you have to use this notation, capital, not its capital, it is a at the rate sign. So, two at the rate sign indicates that when viewed from the nitrogen along the bond to the chiral center, the sequence of substituent hydrogen, methyl and carboxylate appears clockwise. So, it is a L-alanine. Similarly, if it is only a single at the rate between the carbon and hydrogen, this indicates that when viewed from the nitrogen along the bond chiral center, the sequence of hydrogen, methyl and carboxylate appears anti-clockwise. So, this is a D-alanine. So, in this way, dear friends, you can represent the stereochemistry of the compound. So hope with this some basic smile specification rule, you will be able to represent the smiles notation for different chemical structures, or else if you know the smile notation, you can draw the structure of any chemical compound. So if you are through this smile specification rule, you can try these examples. See, in the first half, the smile notations are given. With the help of this smile notation, you have to draw out the structures. In the second half, the structures are given, and from these structures, can you write down the smile notations? If you can, then yes, you have understand smile notation. But if it is going difficult, then revise this slide again. Check out your answer here. The smile notation first is representing acetic acid, followed by cyclohexane, nitrobenzene, hydroxydiene for the relative smile notations. And for these structures, the smile notation, correct smile notations are given below their structures. So friends, thank you very much for understanding and going through this slide. Have a nice day. Thank you. Keep smiling and subscribe to Quick Learn 360.